I'll briefly go into the history of this sector. So it all started in 1963 when Unit Trust of India was first established. 62 or 63, I'm not too sure. The assets under management at that time with Unit Trust of India were about 25 crores. So these days it looks like a very small amount, but it was significant in those days. And over the course of next 25 years or so, from 25 crores it went to 6,700 crores. And in 1987, public sector banks were allowed to set up mutual funds. So you saw the initial round of SBI Mutual Fund, Bank of Baroda Mutual Fund, Bank of India Mutual Fund, GIC Mutual Fund, all of these starting. Now this period, although as such we can say that it's the history of mutual funds in India, they were not mutual funds in the sense that we understand mutual funds today. Today the way we understand mutual funds is that an asset management company collects funds from investors for a certain scheme. All that money is pooled and invested in accordance with the objectives of the scheme, be it equity, be it debt, be it balanced, whatever the scheme may be. And whatever gains, losses which come from that pool of money are in turn given to the unit holders. They belong to the unit holders. The asset management company just charges a fee for managing the assets. This period was not like that, very surprisingly. This entire period was a government controlled kind of environment. So people who are familiar with the history of Unit Scheme 64, it was a mutual fund scheme which would collect money from people, invest in debt securities, equity securities, but there was no concept of a net asset value, no concept of a NAV. Year to year, the fund would generate returns. Those generated returns could be higher or lower than the dividend that they paid out. The public was unaware of the net asset value. There was a fixed income like dividend paid out, and people were investing in the scheme almost like debt instruments. The entire gains, losses were borne effect or hidden from the public and were borne by the institution. Now this got them into trouble around the year 2000 when they were overextended in tech stocks and things like that. That's a separate history. But even the PSU banks, even the PSU banks that came in over here, came in with what were then called as assured return schemes. So these had the brand name of a PSU bank, plus they were giving fabulous returns guaranteed. So you had all these schemes like BOI, D2 square and CAN triple and those kind of things. So public was happy, it's a PSU, we are giving money and there's an assured return, at this period we'll get this much back. And some of these institutions got into trouble because the achieved returns were much lower than the assured returns. So that is a separate history. So since we say it started in 63, but that is actually not a mutual fund history. Actual history of mutual funds, one can say, started somewhere around here when private sector players were allowed in the space. So around this time, 47,000 crores of AUM was there with mutual funds, and gradually around this time again SEBI came into existence, controller of capital issues, and that was removed. All the mutual fund rules, regulations came in, and things became more structured from this point onwards. So around this time, 47,000 crores 10-year period, 47 grew to 1,22,000 crores, and 2003 to 2017, now we have 21.5 lakh crore assets under management. So of late it has seen a lot of growth and lot of money has come into the mutual fund space.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme related documents carefully.